Welcome students to our new lecture. In previous lecture we had seen about the solutions of equations, that is theta equation and phi equation. We had seen it in our last lecture. We were dealing with the problem on particle on a sphere. In that we had derived the two equations based on the two variables that we have taken, theta and phi. So we got the zenith angle or zenith equation and the azimuthal equations. Then we had solved those zenith equation and azimuthal equations, and we had got the overall wave function as psi of lm equal psi of lm of theta phi equals plm of theta into fm of theta, where plm of theta can be given as the solution was given as plm cos theta into 1 upon root 2 pi e to the power of I m phi, where n is a normalization factor, where n we had got it as normalization factor, and this part is our theta equation, and this part is for phi equation, zenith equation and the azimuthal equations respectively. These are also called as spherical harmonics. This represents spherical harmonics and is also called as Laplace harmonics. Laplace harmonics, which gives the special functions which describes the motion of a particle on the surface of the sphere. And they are employed in solving partial differential equations. The partial differential equations that we can get it for different values of L and M. We have two variables here. We have two quantum numbers that we have got it. Two quantum numbers we have obtained from the solutions of these equations, that was L and M. These two quantum numbers can take different values. And for different values of these two quantum numbers, we get the spherical harmonics. These spherical harmonics are of the type for L is equal to 0 and M is equal to 0. We will get psi of 0, 0 as 1 upon under root 2 pi. This is for psi of L equals 0 and M equals to 0. The first digit represents L value and the second digit represents the M value. So for two quantum numbers L and M, we get psi of 0, 0 as 1 upon under root 2 pi. When we increase the L value from 0 to 1 and keeping M as constant 0, we get psi of 1, 0 as under root of 3 upon 4 pi cos theta. Now, when we see it for this, there were no theta or phi term were absent. Theta and phi term were absent for L equals 0 and M equals to 0. Because as m is equal to 0, the orientations will be lesser. So we will get this. L and m both gives us the orientations. So when both are absent, it will be both theta and phi terms will be absent in the wave function. When l equals to non-zero value, we will get the theta term there. Phi term will be still absent because phi term is represented by m value only. M value represents the phi term, as our equation is plm of theta into fm of phi. So phi is represented by m while theta is represented by l and m. So when m is equal to 0, still theta term will be present, but if m is equal to 0, phi term vanishes. So we do not get the phi term for m is equal to 0. So psi 1 0 is under root of 3 by 4 pi cos theta. Similarly, L equals 1 and M equals plus 1. M can take values. We can have L value can be 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. While M can take values from minus L to 0 to plus L. The values of M runs from minus L to plus L. And for L value, L runs from 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So if we have, say, L is equal to 1, M will be equal to, the possible values for M will be minus 1, 0, plus 1. three values will be there for L equals to 1. For L is equal to 2, we will have M goes from minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, and plus 2. So, five values are possible for M quantum number. So, similarly, we can have the number of values for M can be taken from L. L gives us the possible values for M, and that is magnetic quantum number. So, here when L is equal to 1, M is equal to plus 1, that will give us the psi 1 plus 1 under root of 3 by 8 pi sine theta e to the power of I pi, where this I denotes the complex number. I denotes the complex number. So, the function is a complex function. This function was a real function, while this is a complex function. This I denotes the complex number, where I equals under root of minus 1 that we have studied in our mathematics. So, for all values where M is non-zero, we will have this I term will always be present here. So, this I term gives us the complex form of the wave function and not the real form of the wave function. So, we need to derive this real form of the wave function after manipulating, after solving this particular equation. We have to transform it into the real form. So, these are some of the equations for different L and M values. L goes from 0 to 2 and M from 0 to plus 1, minus 1. So, for every non-zero M value, we have a I terms are there, or the complex terms are there. So, majority of our equations are all complex terms will be present, as there are M values will be non-zero. So, we will have a complex terms are present for that. So, what we need to do is we need to change them into real terms. That is spherical harmonics. In real terms, we can transform this complex form spherical harmonics into real form by a simple transformation. The disadvantage with this complex form is that we cannot derive any real or meaningful picture cannot be drawn from this complex function. So, we need to transform it into real forms by a simple mathematical conversion, where we take e to the power of I pi plus e to the power of minus I pi equals cos 2 cos pi, and e to the power of I pi minus e to the power of minus I pi is taken as 2i sin pi. So, when we use these two transformations, we can convert this complex functions that we have obtained, its spherical harmonics, where non-zero M were there. So, those complex terms can be converted into real functions. For example, we can convert for psi 1 plus 1 and psi 1 minus 1 can be converted into real forms. Both this psi plus 1 and psi minus 1, these two, both of them are complex functions are there. So, we can combine these two and then use the relationship for transforming it into real terms. So, real forms can be obtained for these two equations, and those real forms are 1 by root 2. We will not go for derivation of these. Psi of 1 plus 1 plus psi of 1 minus 1 will give us. This is also called as psi 1 plus, where we are having adding the two wave functions. So, this is given as under root 3 by 4 sin theta cos pi and 1 upon I root 2 psi of 1 plus 1 minus psi of 1 minus 1, which is also said as psi of 1 minus, as we are doing minus or subtracting the two wave function. So, psi of 1 minus, which is given as under root 3 by 4 sine theta sine phi. Let this be our equation number 2 and this be our equation number 3. So these two equations we can obtain it from psi of 1 plus 1 and psi of 1 plus 1 and psi of 1 minus 1. Both of them are complex forms, but now what we have got is a real form. Here there is no complex number is not present, so it is a real form. But the disadvantage for this is, one of the major disadvantage for this is the information about information of m is lost. Here we do not know what is the value of m, whether it is plus 1 or minus 1, that cannot be said from these equations. Just we can know that it is psi 1 plus and psi 1 minus, because this is combination of psi 1 plus 1 and psi 1 minus 1. So the information about the m quantum number is undetermined, or it is not determined using this particular transformation, but otherwise it gives us the real form equations. The physical significance for these spherical harmonics can be obtained by drawing the graphs related to different values of this wave function. The physical representation of spherical harmonics or Laplace harmonics can be obtained by plotting the function. Let's say the simplest one is a psi 0 0, which is also given as 1 upon under root 2 pi. So this, when we plot it for different values of theta, what we get is this function is a independent of theta, independent of variable theta and pi. Both of them are not present in this function. So for all values of theta, this psi of 0, 0 is constant. So for all values of theta and pi, psi 0, 0 is constant. It remains constant. So what happens is, whenever we plot this, we get a spherical shape for this. We get a spherical shape where this suppose is a z-axis, this y-axis, and this gives us the x-axis. So it is the same on all the three axes, with the same distance r from origin. So that r will be equal to 1 upon root 2 pi. This r will be equal to 1 upon root 2 pi. So it gives us the same function. So it gives a spherical or sphere. It represents a surface of the sphere. So psi 0 0 represents surface of sphere, which is similar to s orbitals, which is similar to s orbital. Where we can show the s orbital as the one s orbital is somewhat like this, where it is a sphere representing the surface of the sphere. The electron will be moving on this surface of the sphere, so it is more or less like a problem, like a particle on a sphere. So the psi 0 0 represents the one s orbital or the s orbital in general. When we go further, for say, when we are taking it psi of 1, 0, where L equals 1 and M equals to 0, if we take it, that is also a real function. So that function is under root 3 by 4 pi into cos theta. Here, pi is constant, phi is constant or it is independent. The function is independent of phi value. Phi does not appear in this. So the wave function is independent of phi value, means it does not exist on the xy plane, because phi angle was along the xy plane. So it does not represent the xy plane over there. It represents only in the along the z axis. Theta is the when we had taken it spherical harmonics, what we had seen was, if these are the three axes, if this is z axis, y axis and x axis, if the particle is over here, then this angle we had depicted it as theta angle, while its projection on the xy plane, whatever the angle was making with the x axis, that was equal to phi angle. Now, as the phi is remaining constant or is independent of the phi, so the particle is moving along the z axis only. It is not present on the xy plane. Xy plane, it is not present, but it is having existence on the z axis. So when we vary for different theta values, what we get is we get the values of psi 1 0. If we take it say for theta, what will be the cos theta values? For zero, theta value 0, we have cos theta equals 1. For theta equals 0, cos 0 is 1. Then we can have it for 30 degrees, we can have it for 45, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 120 degree, 150 degrees and 180 degrees. That is for 0, then here it is pi by 2 and here it is pi. So we can get the values for different values of theta. We can obtain for different theta values, we can obtain the value of this wave function psi of 1 0. We can get it for theta equals 30 degree. We have the value of cos theta is root 3 by 2. Similarly, for cos 60 it is half, cos 90 is 0, cos 120 is minus half, cos 150 is minus root 3 by 2 and cos 180 degree is minus 1. So if you plot this over the graph, then what we get is, for different values we can get, it suppose for our convenience, if this is representing the xy plane and this representing the positive z axis, while this representing the negative z axis, then for theta equals 0, our theta is the angle with z axis. So theta equals 0 means it is along the z axis, so that will be equal to 1. So psi of 1 0 becomes root 3 by 4, under root of 3 by 4 pi. So it will be having the maximum value for that, and then it keep on decreasing as we increase the angle. As we increase the angle at 60 degree, it becomes half of the value that was at 0 degree. So for 30 degree we can have it, for 60 degree we can have it over here, this is for 90 degrees, this for 120 degrees and for 150 degrees, and here it will be for 180 degrees. So for theta equals 0, if this is the value, for 30 degree it will be somewhere here, the value will be there. For 60 degrees it will be somewhere here we get it. So when we trace it, this will be coming over somewhat like this, because at 90 degree it is equal to 0. Again, when we go for the down side negative axis, we get the values somewhat like this. If we traverse it on the other side, then we get the values like this. The shape for this will be of this type, where two lobes are there, one on the positive z axis lobe and the second lobe is on the negative z axis, while there is a node or the point at which there is zero wave function is there, that we call it as node. node is the point where there is the wave function does not exist. The particle does not exist over there, then that is called as a node. So here we find the node at xy plane, that is 90 degree theta. When it is 90 degree, there is a zero function is present, that is particle does not exist at the theta equals 90. So a node is present there, and that node is on the xy plane. So for psi of 10, there is node on xy plane. So xy plane is also called nodal plane for psi of 10. For psi of 10, xy plane is nodal plane, where the wave function does not exist. So overall, we can depict that picture as one for a p orbitals, which are very much similar to p orbital. This wave function, this traversing the path will be very much similar to p orbital along the z axis. So we can have it as a pz orbital, where along the xy plane there is a zero or the node is present along the xy plane, and we have a lobe on the positive z axis and another lobe on the negative z axis. So this way we can represent the different picture for the nodal planes. If we plot it for psi of 1 minus and psi of 1 plus, then also we get the similar values. We get it for psi of 1 plus and psi of 1 minus also. Psi of 1 plus will be along as it contains sine theta cos phi, so it will be along the x axis, and psi of 1 minus, which contains sine theta sine phi, that will be along the y axis. So psi of 1 plus represents the px orbital, while psi of 1 minus represents py orbital, while psi of 10 represents the pz orbital. This can be depicted or can be easily found out from the wave functions, from the angle that we have it, and angular variables that we have. For psi of 10, the angular variable was cos theta. Angular variable only we are depicting. So psi of 10, angular variable was cos theta. When we go for the equation for psi of 10, for this equation we have psi of 10 equals some constant into cos theta. So variable was cos theta for psi of 10. Similarly, for psi of plus 1, 1 plus it is sine theta cos phi, and psi of 1 minus it is sine theta sine. These angular variables are important to consider for the orientations of the orbital. Psi of 10 is cos theta is the variable. Psi of 1 plus is sine theta cos phi, and psi of 1 minus is sine theta sine phi. Now, if you remember, when we had transformed our functions from the angular variables to from the Cartesian coordinates to the spherical coordinates, when we had transformed it in from Cartesian coordinate to spherical coordinate, what we had got it was for x, it was r sine theta cos phi. For y, it was r sine theta sine phi, and for z, it was r cos theta. So from this, what we can correlate is that this cos theta term is in this phi of 10, so it orients along the z axis. It orients along z axis, and hence it represents pz orbital. While the sine theta cos phi is similar to psi of 1 plus, so it orients itself along x-axis and represents px orbital, and represents the px orbital. While y, we have sine theta sine phi, which is very much similar to the angular variable part in psi of 1 minus, that is sine theta sine phi. So this particular orbital represents, or it varies along the, orients along the y-axis and represents py orbital. This represents the py orbital. So from the angular part, that is angular variable part, we can find out where the orientation of the orbital will be, whether it will be along the z-axis, along x-axis, or along the y-axis. So this was for spherical harmonics, which are also called as Laplace spherical harmonics, which gives us the real pictures as well as the complex pictures. And when we transform it into real pictures, it gives us the shapes of the orbitals. What are different shapes of orbitals that we can obtain it from this particular solving the Laplace spherical harmonics.